7 is called the State of Texas versus Christopher Chambliss that year.
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
Present with your attorney, Mr. West, and the state's attorney. Does the defendant waive a formal reading of the indictment and the arraignment here? Can we proceed in summary?
Yes, Your Honor, please.
In summary, this indictment alleges that on or about February 14th, 2024, in Jefferson County, Texas, you committed the third-degree felony of assault on a public servant. Do you understand what you're charged with?
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
If convicted, you face a term of not more than 10 years or less than 2 years in prison. In addition, a fine may be assessed not to exceed $10,000. Do you understand?
Yes, sir, Your Honor, I do.
Agreement's been reached. You would be pleading guilty, sentenced to 10 years in prison. That would be suspended. You would be placed on regular probation for 10 years. Is that your understanding of the agreement?
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
If I follow this agreement, you have no right of appeal. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
How do you plead to this indictment? Guilty or not guilty? Guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
You're hesitating. Are you guilty or not?
Guilty.
Are you pleading guilty voluntarily and because you are guilty?
I was off my medications.
Are you pleading guilty because you are guilty?
Yes, sir, Your Honor, I do.
Show me what's marked as State's Exhibit 1. Did you sign that document voluntarily?
Yes, sir.
Did you understand it? Discuss it with your attorney?
Yes, sir.
All the contents true and correct?
Yes, sir, Your Honor.
State's Exhibit 1 is tendered into it.
No objection.
Without objection, admitted. Among other things, this states you are mentally competent to enter your guilty plea, which is freely and voluntarily made. You know what you've been charged with. The indictment's been read to you. You've read it. You were guilty of the crime charged in any lesser included offenses. You were giving up your rights to a jury trial and the rights to the appearance, confrontation, cross-examination of witnesses. You were totally satisfied with the representation provided by your lawyer. All of this is true. It states, so help you God. State's yes, Exhibit sir. 1 is made a part of the record for all purposes. Without objection?
Oh, yeah, no objection.
It's a pre-sentence report, one.
Yes. Please, Your Honor, yes.
How long have you been in jail now? Did you say? A long time? Months? Since, weeks? Days? What?
Weeks. August 15th.
What are the injuries to this lady, please?
She had a bruise, Your Honor. He was there on a detention hold.
What was her damages?
There was no damages.
No physical injuries? It was observed.
As far as damages, there was no money that she wasn't treated. She just had some bruising, I believe.
She was struck in her face with his hand and, let's see, used his head to strike her in the face. I observed physical injuries. He also spit saliva on her, landing on her neck area, it says. How can you hit somebody with your head in the face and, you know, not cause some kind of harm?
Well, there was bruising.
She didn't have any medical bills or anything like that. There's no restitution. There's no restitution, but there was.
Okay.
He did bruise her. And like he said a moment ago, Your Honor, one of the big issues was he was there for a medical issue. And
it
was
the big issue is he competent or not?
Oh, he is competent. Yeah.
Then it's not then there's no defense there, is it?
No, we're not saying a defense.
Okay.
Let's
not waste our time.
Yeah.
Either is responsible or not.
Yeah. And he's
but
been content.
You hit somebody in the face, a woman, and you hit him in the face, which results in this third degree felony. And, and they're a public servant, namely a nurse at the hospital, trying to provide medical care to the person who assaults. Okay. That's all. We got a battery running low, which is not a surprise here.
We just have technology issues, it seems like.
How much time does it show? He was in custody. Anything else on this?
My sure.
I'm going to find you have pleaded guilty voluntarily. You were mentally competent to do so. You understand and appreciate the consequences of pleading guilty. There's sufficient evidence supporting your guilty plea. The state's exhibit one admitted here. To find you guilty beyond a reason of doubt. I'm going to find you guilty beyond a reason of doubt. I'm following this agreement. You are hereby sentenced to confinement. In the institutional division of the Texas Department of Criminal Justice to serve a term of 10 years. That will be suspended. You are placed on regular probation for 10 years. There is no fine here. There will be terms and conditions of probation, which are normal and customary for this type of offense. Can you tell me a little bit about what the situation was here?
Situation?
With him? Well, yeah. Why was he in the hospital?
I believe it was, I don't have to keep it right in front of me.
It was an emergency detention hearing dealing with his some psychiatric issues, Your Honor, where they had brought him in to the hospital, and that's what they were trying to essentially treat him for on that unit. You know.
Well, I'm concerned about headbutting and striking a nurse.
Yes, sir.
They are they're pretty special people.
Yeah.
When it comes to taking care of people, because if they weren't there, who would be? If the doctors need them, so who would be? The point being is, I can put somebody in jail up to 180 days, and when you assault people who are in a position of special providing of public service, then you pay for it on my watch.
Your Honor, if I could respond, I think he's had some issues back then. He's been competent lately. Before he was actually arrested, he and I had been in contact. He had called my office because he knew I was a court appointed attorney while the warrant was pending. He was actually in, was it Alabama? He was in another state.
Georgia.
Okay. I knew it was somewhere that way. He was in Georgia, whatever. Me and him were coordinating back and forth, trying to get him, figure out what's going on in the case. He's been competent. He's never denied doing this. He's always been very,
And he's charged with, intentionally, knowingly, or recklessly causing
bodily injury. Yes, and so he understands that.
He's accepting responsibility. He's
absolutely, Your Honor.
But you don't assault somebody, especially hit a woman in the face of a nurse and sashay out of here without paying a price.
Well, and another thing, Your Honor, he's currently expecting his first child. When is it due?
I'm more worried about the, you know what I'm worried about is the victim.
I understand.
The person who is not paid to be punched in the face.
Absolutely. I understand.
When they're trying to care. I would serve 180 days in jail as a condition of, you served how long?
Your Honor, I would ask
4 months
to abate that and see if how he does on probation. And if he's messing up, then do it. But I think he's going to be okay on probation.
If he messes up on probation, you're looking at 10 years. But right now, you're going to do 4 months in. Four more months, you just don't punch a care provider in the face. Sorry. That's just it.
Your Honor, I did ask her nicely 3 times to back up out of my face. I did ask her nicely. I said, ma'am, please back up out of my face 3 times.
You did. You said what to her?
I said, she was all up in my face, and I asked her 3 times. I'm like, ma'am, please back up out of my face. I'm off my meds, really. I was off my meds. For like
so you remember months. All of that?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, sir. Yes,
well, Honor, just to be clear, Your Honor, it was a security officer there at the hospital that were
dealing here's with the deal is says security officer.
Yes.
It says I want to be. Well, do you see what this indictment says? I mean, I'm reading the indictment. It says, assaulted Linda DeMoss, a public servant, namely a nurse at St. Elizabeth Hospital. Is that wrong or right?
Yes, Your Honor, that's incorrect. It should be the
well, the indictment is wrong?
Yes.
Well, we can't be pleading guilty to something that's wrong if everybody knows about it.
Yes, sir.
I didn't realize that. Like I, said, I
wouldn't.
I don't have that in front of me.
Yes, sir.
Do, Your Honor.
That was security guard is also
still
protected
public. Yes,
person,
sir.
Yeah, absolutely.
But a nurse is not in a position to be able to defend themselves like a security personnel may be able to.
I do think we need, maybe need to make an amendment from the,
Yes, Your Honor.
Yeah, I don't think it makes changes the, doesn't change the crime.
Y'all gotta correct this. I mean, I'm heading out in one direction thinking this is a nurse. Nobody's saying anything until at the end of all of this. And it's apples and oranges. I made a big speech about protecting the public servant and nurse.
Yeah, it's not.
I'm gonna do that because they're not, they're trying to help people, not to defend themselves. And security person is in a different position.
Still public servant, still falls with that.
So what do y'all want to do in this indictment? This can't be.
Move to amend.
This can't be wrong or else we're doing.
Yeah, I think it takes amendment to amend that, just change nurse to a security officer. And we don't object to that. That's.
Okay, what is the word? Yeah, I'm taking out nurse here at your request. And what should it be? Security officer?
Yes, Your Honor.
And then it goes on to say to wit, in the lawful discharge of an official duty, to wit or namely providing medical care to the defendant. Well, that's not right either. That security person providing medical care. So what are we doing? What do we say for that?
Why don't we do this since I will be here back here in the morning. I know Mr.
What do you want to put in here so we can move on? So everybody can move on with their life because I'm going to follow this agreement as it is. Just fix it though.
And they were helping.
I'm sorry. It's just, an indictment is ought to be accurate.
Then let's give us a little moment to me and Mr. Boyd to work out the actual language we need to get in here because that's.
They were actually bringing him in the psychiatric area for treatment. It was in that, doing that and in there.
In lawful discharge of an official duty, to wit, providing security to the hospital?
Yes, Your Honor.
Works. It's up to the statement.
Well, if it works, is it right or not?
Yes, Your Honor. We need to.
Are we, you swear to God?
Yeah.
I mean, we're just.
Well.
You had to look at this. No, is that what he's, is that what this person's doing?
Yes.
Providing.
Yes, Your Honor.
Providing security at the hospital.
Yes, Your Honor.
That's what this person's on duty for doing.
All right, corrected. To state the victim was a public servant providing a public servant, namely a security officer at St. Elizabeth Hospital in the lawful discharge of an official duty, to wit, or namely providing security for the hospital. That's good.
Yes, Your Honor.
Perfect, Your Honor.
All right. And I've issued the statement, you're sentenced to 10 years in prison, that is suspended, you are placed on regular probation, there will be terms and provisions that are normal and customary, please see the probation officer. Do you understand if you fail, your probation could be revoked, you could be sentenced up to 10 years in prison?
Is the upfront time still part of it or is that?
No. And I don't mean to be lied to a public, to a security official.
It's a little different.
But a nurse is not in a position to defend themselves.
Yes, I understand.
And they're like a doctor at a hospital. And they're going to be, you pay a price.
Yeah.
Security, you also pay a price and he's got a felony conviction now.
Exactly. Thank you.